Well, it's a fairly nice day in the middle of November. You don't expect that here in Maine. So what I'm going to do is try to take a different type of ride today. It's Saturday afternoon, so I hope there's not going to be too much traffic. Didn't realize how fast I was going there for a minute. I haven't been on a bike in a while. So 38 miles an hour is feeling a little fast. So what I'm gonna try to do is see if I can go up to the covered bridge. It really isn't that far away, but it's main roads all the way, so. We'll see how far I get. And it's been pouring out, but it was supposed to rain all day today, but it stopped raining. So this is Wilson Road, and I'll go all the way down here. And there. The end of this, I should run into Hurricane Road. And that's where the covered bridge will be. Up on the right here is the White Rock Grange. That's the grange that Patty and I belong to. Now, I joined, maybe a year or two ago. And at the same time, Patty was getting her 50-year pin. So some of the old timers in there, been with the grange for a long time, and I was talking to one of them. I said, you know, Bill, I can't wait till I get my 50-year pin. And he looked at me and took me aside a little bit and said, Gary, you know, you have to belong to the Grange for 50 years. You know, I was like 70, right? You have to belong to the Grange for 50 years to get your 50-year pin. And I said, oh, yeah, geez, I see what you mean, Bill. I should have joined last year. Oh, Bill thought that was pretty funny. Let's see, I got the Akazo Brave 7, and I've got my modified mic on, tucked inside my shirt. So, a modified external mic. And it is pretty windy today. Well, I can't tell by the leaves, but Stafford Bridge. Stafford Bridge Road, let's see what happens. This has been repaved within the last, I think, 3 or 4 years. Made it real nice. Roads are still wet, so I'm gonna take it a little bit easy. Well, we'll take a stop a little bit on the way back. This is pretty steep coming up here. I'm surprised we're still picking up speed. You gotta admit, the Kepler's got some power. I suppose I could pedal a little and help, but kind of nice to have a covered bridge so close to your house. people up along the other side. Always nice to get some good shots. Too bad about that. What do you think? How's that look? Pretty good? Seems like that was kind of a short ride. But I really enjoyed this aerial ride of Kepler. It's been just a lot of fun for me. Good looking bike. Fun's good. Got plenty of power, as you can, of course, everybody knows that already, but there's more to it than that. It's funny how things change, but what you think you need in the bike at first is you get to riding it, you realize it isn't the same. And now we're going to be looking for one for my wife, something for her. One thing that we're looking at is a Electric XP 3.0. It is. Yeah, a little battery power doesn't hurt anything, does it? I haven't run it out for. I've never run it so far that it's gone out. 75 miles.
Really?
80 miles. Yeah, depending on whether I do some pedaling with it or just throttle all the way, or because it does have pedal assist, and which is something I never thought I would use. Pedal assist on it, and it's all I like doing.
Depending on pedal, does that do any charging of the battery or not?
No, it doesn't. Now, there are some that have that, but it's regenerative when you brake or slow down that they'll charge.
Yeah.
But they get into way more money than what this is, and they also have some drawbacks too. First, it doesn't charge that much.
Uh-huh.
And second, it slows you down instead of coasting, so.
Okay.
So.
And you don't have to have a license for it?
No.
Now, do you have to have a motorcycle license to ride it?
No. Uh-huh. I mean, I have one anyway, but. No, I when I looked at these, I got this model because I wanted the little extra speed that this has,
uh-huh.
but it's still a Class 2 bike, so it can go on any bicycle trails. It's a Class 2, so Class 1, 2, and 3 e-bikes, and it can go on any trail that's marked for bicycles only.
Okay.
Even if it says no motorized, you can still go on it in this state. In most states, you can.
Uh-huh.
But if you, and I put it in Class 2 and I go on the trails like that. And it won't go over 20 miles an hour when I do that. So that's safe. But when I go out on a road like this, coming down here, I don't want cars zipping by me and stuff like that. So I can do about 41 miles an hour.
So is that like your top speed?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's still not too bad for back
like today. That'd be a
distance. Yeah. Oh, yeah. middle of November, and I looked outside and went, whoa.
Good day for a ride.
It's a good day for a ride, and I wanted to do a YouTube videos. You'll be on YouTube, guys. You mind?
That's okay. That's okay.
Florida?
We're not local. Local. We're from Colorado.
Oh, wow. You guys are all over.
Oh, yeah. We're enjoying it.
Yeah.
Perfect weather for them to come visit.
Well, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Very informative. Appreciate
you guys have a good day.
Thank you. You have a beautiful ride.
Yeah, it's always nice to run into some nice people, isn't it? Well, back into the sun again. It's too nice a day to stop riding. You know, the funny thing is, right up until this morning, including this morning, for 2 weeks, I had the worst cold. Oh, boy. Hacking, coughing. Felt miserable. Thank you. know. That vibration, that is a thing, isn't it? What kind of a noise is that? Well, try doing a little more riding. I mean, like I said, nobody really wants to stop riding on a day like this. Temperature might have dropped a couple of degrees. Well, this isn't as wet or muddy as I thought it might be. Not by a long shot. It's not bad. Well, I hope the microphone's holding up well. I got a friend's house that's at the top of that hill. I wonder if I can make it there. It's my buddy's house, and I was sort of hoping I'd run in to be able to get to see his hot rod, which I haven't seen yet. But I guess I won't. Well, thanks for coming along. I enjoyed your company.